All right. Can I be honest with y'all? I don't do stand-up comedy. I'm a fraud. I've really never done stand-up comedy. I'm a professional actor. And to prove to you, I'm going to be above responding to that. Listen, ma'am, I graduated from Harvard University with a theater and a theater degree. Okay, I've been professionally acting for about 17 years. Okay, I was an amateur actor for 7 years before that. I was doing gutter work, street performances for 5 years before that. I've been doing this for 48 years. None of y'all recognize me at all, huh? Does anybody recognize me from acting? Wow, none of y'all have, none of you have seen the Netflix, that Netflix original series, Spartan? Get off the couch, you old silly jelly bean! That's one of the co-stars, that's like the lead in the show, has that catchphrase. You've never seen that? Here's the thing with the problem, I would say, with Hollywood is acting, it doesn't pay anymore. So my manager calls me. Here's why I'm here, y'all. My manager calls me and he goes, you gotta get into the stand-up thing. Everybody is doing stand-up comedy. That's where the money's at. You're getting all these auditions. You're not getting any of them. You're spending all this gas. Why don't you spend all that gas and make some money doing stand-up comedy? He goes, look at the. He goes, look. So you all are familiar with the TV show Lewis? He goes, Louis C.K. from the hit TV show Louis, that dude's doing stand-up now. Christopher Rock from Everybody Hates Christopher. Do y'all remember that actor? He's been hitting the open mics down in Brooklyn. Everybody is doing stand-up comedy. And he goes, so... I don't know. I'm just doing this for the money. I feel like I don't want you all to not... Because you all paid about $50, $55 a head to get in here. To see some primetime comedy, right? Listen, I'm a professional at... Here's what I want to do. I want to do some professional acting at you. I mean, I'm gonna. I want to... And I'm gonna grace you with it. I'm gonna do some professional acting so you feel like you got your money's worth. You can go back, you can tell the babysitter. We saw some pretty wild stand-up comedy up front. And you're never gonna believe. We saw Brian Prouty from the Hulu Amazon collab crossover original series, scoring for it. And your babysitter's probably 13. That's kind of my market, 13 to 17 males. And be like, whoa! So this, you're about to get some, I mean, this ain't going to be your Brown University kind of acting, okay? This is... The Harvard University, located in Connecticut. Okay. Okay, so all that I am going to need is, so that you know this isn't like, this must be one of that, one of his fame. I'm a Texan. This must be one of his famous, one of his famous actings, acting monologues. So if I could get an emotion, I'm best at a very dramatic, emotional actor. If I could get an emotion, let's see, sir, could you just give me an emotion and then I'll do acting for it? Don't act out the emotion. Do you have an emotion, like what's, like verbally? Sadness? All right. It's gonna be real hard with this real upbeat music on it. But I'm not above the challenge. Okay, so sadness. I'll do. So I'm originally from Nebraska, Lincoln specifically. I don't know if anybody else is from the Midwest here. And I'm building a character. And I grew up in Lincoln, and so I've got a lot of family in Lincoln and Iowa. And what we would do, like what the entertainment, we would go like once a year to a family farm that was in between Nebraska and Iowa. And as a kid, like all the cousins would get together. And this particular summer, I was maybe about 8 and my brother was 10. We went to this farm. We run around, play with the pigs, play with the chickens, whatever, you know, just farm stuff, kids farm stuff. And the coolest thing, though, there was these train tracks in the woods of my cousin's farm. And the older teens and preteens, they would go to the train tracks and they would, like, they were old enough, they would get to throw rocks at the train and, like, put pennies on the track and watch them smack, basically try and derail this train. And the absolute coolest thing that they got to do is they would run. They would, like, run along. The train would come, and they would run. I don't know if anybody's done this. They'd run alongside it, and they would jump on the train and just ride it for, you know, a little bit and then jump off, and their youthful bodies wouldn't break or anything. And that was, like, so cool. And I was looking at this. I was 8, and I was way too young to do it, and it was, like, the coolest thing. And in our family, it was like, oh, someday I'll get to do that. So this particular summer, my dad points to me, 8-year-old me, 10-year-old brother, Adam John County, looks at him and me, and he goes, let's go down to the woods. And this isn't going to get weird. So my dad takes me and my brother down, just us two, and me and my brother are looking at each other like, what? It's happening. He's going to teach us how to mess around with this train. We're a little too young for it. We can't tell mom. And he strictly said, you cannot tell my mom, Jenny County. And so we get to the train track, and he goes, all right, I'm going to teach y'all how to jump off, pay close attention. We're going to do this. We wait a little bit. The train, it takes a minute for the train to come. So we see the train coming, and it's going, and it's like, trains are pretty long. And it goes like 20 cars, and it's just like, ta-chish, ta-chish. And my dad's just on the edge. Like ready to jump on, and it's like, why hasn't he done it yet? Me and my brother look at each other and we're like, is this when we find out our dad's actually a coward? This man we thought was invincible. And then finally the tail end of the train comes, and it's like the last two cars, and we see him just kind of, his little dad bod just starts running alongside the train, and we go, oh, he's just going to show us how to do it, and then we'll do it next time. It's going to be whatever. Still exciting. So he jumps on the last car, barely gets it, grabs onto the rail, and starts going. And he goes like maybe like 25 yards, and then does like a little. We were watching, and he does kind of a little thing. Doesn't jump off. Goes like another 60 yards, and me and my brother are just like focused. We're like, we need to get this dismount correct so we don't break our little bones and never are allowed to do anything cool in the rest of our lives. He probably gets about 100 yards down. And he does this like movement, and me and my brother are focused, and my dad, he just went. And then just turned, he did that until he was just a dot in the sunset. And we never saw our father again after that day. So I'm going to do the sadness that me and my brother Adam John County felt being abandoned and left alone in the woods of Nebraska by our one loving father, Kevin County. So this is sadness. That's just me getting into character. All right. Y'all have no idea about acting. All right. Okay, sadness. Nebraska. Okay, so this is going to be the... we'll do it in post, but this is going to be the train. Okay, and then this will be my father. Yeah, he's a real person. He's not just a hand with little finger legs. Okay, so train, my father, and I'm 8 years old in the woods watching him go into the distance. Okay, got it? This is Harvard University presents Ryan County doing sadness. Thanks, y'all.